Hello, I'm Dr. Young. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. How common are they in the real world? In this video, we will discuss the prevalence of monopolies. While economists often talk about the efficiency of perfectly competitive markets, the reality is that markets are rarely in perfect competition. More commonly, a small number of firms, or even one firm, serves a high share of the market. This high degree of market power often results in market inefficiencies. In the last few years, market concentration has increased dramatically. In the non-manufacturing sector, the concentration ratio, which is the market share held by the largest companies in an industry, passed from 1% to over 9% from 1997 to 2012. Those numbers hide a high degree of variability. In some industries, the current level of market concentration is extreme. As you can see from Figure 1, in 2022, almost 70% of all smartphones owned in the US were produced by either Apple or Samsung. Google has consistently controlled more than 80% of the search engine market in the past 12 years, as shown in Figure 2. Figure 3 shows similar numbers for the operating systems. In 2022, Apple, Windows, and Android were roughly equally dividing 83% of the US operating systems market. These trends are heavily led by the rise of information as a crucial source of economies of scale and the growing role of network economies. The distinctive feature of the knowledge economy is that virtually all costs connected with the collection and development of information are fixed costs. That is, the cost, for instance, of developing a new computer program. Installing and running that same computer program on any device, instead, is virtually free. Network economies are whenever a product or service acquires value when a lot of people use them. It is easy to see how network economies are of primary importance in the technology industry and the overall internet economy. You wouldn't be using social media if your friends were not on it. You would not be buying a new laptop if there were no programs compatible with its operating system. Since both economies of scale and network economies generate market power, market concentration is their unsurprising byproduct. Is market concentration inherently bad? Well, monopolies do not necessarily produce a deadweight loss that justifies a government intervention. For instance, price discrimination, the business practice of charging a different price to different consumers, can be socially efficient. Additionally, on average, employees that work for big companies earn higher wages. Big companies have deeper pockets, and with that comes the ability to invest in research and development that can speed up the pace of technological innovation. Therefore, we can say that market concentration is not bad per se. However, recent data disproves some of the positive views of market power. Net investment as a percentage of operating surplus is on a downward trend, suggesting that market power might not be the most efficient tool to spur research and technological innovation. Employee compensation as a percentage of gross value added has also declined, suggesting that workers do not get fully compensated for the value of their work. These trends have raised concerns in light of the rising levels of inequality in most developed countries. The real question is, does the extreme level of market concentration in these industries demand some form of government intervention? This is still a wide open question. And you, what do you think? So we have seen the prevalence of monopolies in the modern economy and some of their implications. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.